James Harden is still on the Rockets, so he's, I guess, the best, you know, the best player right now on that team, and he played really well. They kind of were comparing it to Dennis Rodman today. Basically, they said even at the height, like when this team was winning games like crazy, he would go out and party. He wouldn't go to practice. The next day, he would show up and drop a 50-point triple-double.
He's obviously uber-talented. I'm not sure he's a great dude. And Daryl Morey being out of there means you can write that franchise off for the foreseeable future, as far as I'm
concerned.
I know.
So my whole thing was, I'm a huge, you know, James Harden guy, but part of my love for James Harden was Daryl Morey and the way he designed the team around James Harden. And you're right.
Right.
I was thinking about this week, mostly today when I was prepping for this podcast. Daryl Morey being out of there ruins the whole thing for me. So let's not dwell on
it. And by the way, if it ruins it for you, you think it doesn't ruin it for James? Like, he...
Right, exactly.
It
but that's
the
owner's fault. But that's the owner's fault. The owner was, you know, speaking out against Daryl Morey. We heard that was caught on tape at the White House or wherever he was, wherever he was talking to. And Daryl Morey was like, oh, yeah, I'm out. Like, and he left that franchise in shambles.
The narrative, right, it just shows you that how media or anybody or perception can paint the narrative. You could paint Harden to be a bad guy, or you could just say, I think if Bill Simmons says he's going to end up in Philly, he'll probably end up in Philly. He may just say, you know what? I don't care if they're going to be a better team right now, but I trust Daryl Morey in the process, no pun intended, even more. And then it just means he's following a GM that he trusts in. That's a very defensible narrative. So anyway, let's see what happens with Daryl.
If that happens and he becomes the most loyal guy in the league again. Hey, my guy was spoken
exactly.
out against and he left. I just was following
That's
him.
My point.
But he talked about Brooklyn before he ever talked about Philadelphia. So why is he going and talking about
All
Brooklyn?
Right.
Why is he ditching practices? Yeah, listen, it's the whole thing is, again, it's all anyone hears these days if you listen to basketball sports media, so I don't want to do that again.
We get it. He's not Mother Teresa, and who knows what his thought process is. But he's not any worse or better than a lot of these other guys.